Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to show you how to prove trig identities without trigonometry. Yeah, it sounds unbelievable, but it is true. Okay, and the deeper thing I'm going to show you is the power of complex numbers. Okay, so instead of using trig to prove trig identities or trig formulae, I'm going to show you how it can be easily done using basic complex numbers. Now, if you've never heard of a complex number before, it doesn't matter. Okay, the only thing you need to know to really understand this presentation is the exponent laws. Okay, and I'll show you those as we go along. So, you know, I kind of think it's a cool thing, and I hope you enjoy it too. So, let me share my screen with you. Here is the identity that we are going to prove. It says the sine of x plus y equals the product of sine x with cos y plus the product of cos x with sine y. Okay, now to do this, you essentially, the standard way, you use triangles. Okay, you use triangles. And yeah, it's the method I'm going to show you today is simpler. Is it better? Maybe, maybe not. It's less visual. It's kind of more algebraic. But anyway, I hope you enjoy it and I hope you find it fun. So let me share my screen with you. We are going to apply the following very important representations for sine and cosine. So if theta's a real number, then I can write sine of theta in the following way. And there's another one for cosine. Okay, now you might be wondering, what is this I here? Well, I is the imaginary unit and it's the basis of complex numbers. And it satisfies the equation I squared equals negative 1. Okay, and you usually see this in, say, senior years in high school or, say, in a first year university mathematics course. But if you haven't seen complex numbers before, don't worry about it. Okay, all right, so where do we go from here? Well, I'm going to start with the complicated and move to the simple. So I'm going to start with the right-hand side, and I'm going to show that that equals the left-hand side. So let's call the identity star. Okay, so the RHS, the right-hand side of star, equals the following. Oh, by the way, before I say, you might say, where does this come from? Well, this comes from a special formula called Euler's formula, which I proved in previous videos. Okay, so the right-hand side of star of these products, so let's write them out in the following way. Oops, that's a y there. Either you have y. Okay, plus the product of these two things. So I'll have the following. And the final one is sine y. Okay. So, where to from here? Well, we're just going to expand the brackets out, apply the exponent laws for multiplication, and we're going to get a bit of cancellation, and that's it. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. Okay, so this is a e to the i y here, all right? Okay, so firstly, we can take out these, you know, this, you've got a 4i here and a 4i here, so you can take this out. And we're going to get a big mess. So let's multiply out like we usually would with these sort of brackets. And if I apply my exponent laws, I can combine the x and the y in the following way. And if I continue to do this, I'll get the following. Okay, times that. That times that. Okay, so this takes care of all of these ones, and now we just got to do the same with this one. Okay, that times that, that times that, that times that, that times that. And that times that. Okay. So if we look carefully now, hopefully, fingers crossed, there's going to be some cancellation. So let's see if we can cross off or cancel some of the terms here. Okay, so you can see this term is going to cancel with this term. So I know some mathematicians don't like it when you cross these things out, but that's what I'm going to do. This term is going to cancel with this term. And what have you got left? Well, we've got two of these terms and two of these terms. So all right, so almost finished now. I can take the two out and cancel, and what am I left with? I'm left with this. What is this? Well, up here, if you look up here, it's just theta replaced by x plus y. What is that? Well, it's sine x plus y. That's the right-hand side. Sorry, the left-hand side of star. So we've shown that the right-hand side of star equals the left-hand side of star. So we're really happy about that. Hooray! Okay, we proved our trig identity. Now, a good question here is it the best proof? Okay, well, what are the negatives of this proof? It's not very geometrical. It's not very visual, but it is algebraical, okay? It is algebraic. So if you like algebra and you don't like geometry or trigonometry, this proof is good, assuming you accept that I is defined via I squared equals negative 1. Okay, so what do you think of the proof? What do you think the pros and cons are? I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. I think it's kind of cool. Do you know any other proofs without using trigonometry or without using geometry? I'd love to see those as well. So if you have any questions, any comments, you can post a comment section in the comment in the comment section below the video. Hope you found it useful. And if you, there's one take-home thing for this presentation, just one, okay? And it's the following. I used complex numbers to prove this identity, okay? What this hopefully illustrates to you is the power of complex numbers. Complex numbers can help simplify so many calculations in mathematics, okay? And it's not just trig identities. It's integration. It's solving partial differential equations. Complex numbers and their use are everywhere in mathematics. And instead of making things more complicated or more complex, complex numbers actually simplify things. So why should you learn about complex numbers? Why? Because they simplify things, they give you another method of attack on problems, and they're worth learning. So let me know what you think about complex numbers. Let me know what you think of the proof. If you have any feedback, I would love to hear it. Okay? Thanks for watching. Hope you found the video useful. I'll sign off now.